From the campus of Irving MacArthur High School, it's the ICTN Game of the Week. Tonight, District 7, 6A Boys High School Basketball, the Nimitz Vikings against the MacArthur Cardinals, the season finale in district play. Hi, everybody. Rob Willman with you. John Nelson will join us here in just a minute. This game being taped on Valentine's Day, so happy Valentine's to all of those as we get ready for the introductions of MacArthur. Coming in tonight, Nimitz 0-13 in district play. Boy, wouldn't they like to finish the regular season on a winning note and picking up that first district win. MacArthur 5-8, both teams out of the playoffs. The standings as they are right now, Cedar Hill a perfect 13-0, Duncanville and DeSoto 10-3, and the Warriors from South Grand Prairie at 8-5. So no Irving team will make postseason, just like their female counterparts. We'll talk more about that as the game unwinds. Mac has won 9 in a row, 17 of the last 20 in these matchups. It is senior night, and it will be nothing but seniors that get the start for Toby Martin and company. Let's take a look at the starting lineups in tonight's ball game, and we'll start off those with the visiting Vikings. Mac Evans, a sophomore. Justin Sherman, who had a big game last time out on ICTN. Chavarria at guard. Destin Ecke, he's their playmaker. And Pedro Torres, a 5'10 senior guard, your starter for Joel Donaldson, who only has two seniors on his team. On the flip side of that, for Toby Martin and company, he's going to start every senior he's got that's healthy. Zay Booker, who's been here since day one, it seems like. Jackson, the 6-foot guard. Johnson, the 5'11 guard. Martez Cash and Ken McGinnis, the 6'3 post. As you take a look at the MacArthur Cardinal huddle right there, they had all of the seniors early on that were recognized with their parents before game time. But that doesn't matter now. Now, last week on ICTN against Irving, MacArthur just came out on fire. They hit 5 3-pointers in the first quarter. And the first one to hit them all was their freshman, the 6'4 freshman, Blake Burris. But tonight, since it is senior night, it'll be all seniors getting a nod for MacArthur. MacArthur's in the white as you take a look at Toby Martin there. Nimitz in the purple, trimmed in white. And as we await the basketball, hopefully no one has done a Tom Brady on us and stole the basketball. There it is on the far side. We're about ready to jump at center stage. And with the call,
John Nelson.
All right, Rod, in the jump circle, Destin Ecke, the 6'6 junior. It's dipped, and it's still loose and controlled by the Cards as they go left to right. Mack averaging right at 60 points a game this year. Zay Booker goes right side to Robert Johnson. Mack won the first game last month by 11, 59-48 the drive and the foul as Martez Cash trying to convert the first two of the game. It'll go to the line and have to earn these two from the stripe. 6'2 senior, 1 of 8 for head coach Toby Martin. Toby 9-2 against Nimitz. And a 1-0 lead for the Cards.
Well, it took all of, 18 seconds to draw a foul.
Cards coming off a 66-50 loss to Duncanville. But they have won two of their last three as that one rims out. And the first possession for Nimitz. 2-19 overall, 0-13 in district play, coming off a loss to DeSoto, 50-38 last week. Angel Chavarria, lob feed into Ecke. Ecke backing in, will let it fly, and will go to the line. And just like Martez Cash, he will shoot twice.
That reminds me of the very first game we did. Might have been Red Oak and Nimitz last year, where it seemed like every trip down the court, we'd have a foul.
Well, let's hope history doesn't repeat itself. Destin had 16 in the first meeting, averaging 15 points and 9 rebounds a game. He is the glass eater for the Vikings this year, and they lead it 2-1. Robert Johnson. Johnson had a nice game the first go around, had 13. This is McGinnis in trouble. Booker comes to the rescue and tipped out of bounds off of Nimitz. And Yusuke Jackson at side court will give way to Ken McGinnis. And a deep toss to Zay Booker, who had 14 in the first contest. Cards have had it pretty much their way in recent history over the Vikings, having won 9 in a row. Chavarria, front course toss to Pedro Torres, who makes it fly over to the middle. Chavarria on one side, Vivian Hopkins on the other, and now the switch with Ecky. Looking for Chavarria, cutting through Ecky, and he draws contact, driving on Martez Cash, team foul number 2 on Mac.
You know, that's a good matchup for Joel Donaldson and company. And very quickly now, Soares, the sophomore, comes off the bench for Coach Martin and company. But I think that's a good matchup for the Vikings.
Rodrigo Soares, the only freshman, long three is short. Run down underneath by Mack. Now Nimitz with a shot, another shot. Myron Collins, the sophomore, able to get a couple of shot offs, but then Jackson got a piece of him, team foul number 3.
Well, they're consistent. Toby is questioning the official. Just to the bottom of your screen, you can see the official there. Toby asking a few questions on that call, and that was the holdup before Evans tries the free throw.
And sinks the first. Nimitz's last win came right before district, as they beat W.T. White 56-47. That's the last time that they tasted success in a tough task tonight. Three-pointer on the way. That one launched by Soares. Front court, Justin Sherman. Sherman averaging 7 a game this year. Drives on Johnson, dumps it off to Ecky. It's kicked and retrieved by Chavarria. And the senior, fronted by McGinnis, gets rid of it. Into Ecky. Ecky on McGinnis, and he walked with it. And a turnover at 5:48.
Nice defense that time against Ecky. Waiting to see how long it'll take Martin to put in what I call his triplets. They already have Soares, but Starks and Key, those three sophomores, who scored most of the points in last week's win over Irvin.
Zay Booker goes behind Soares. Will let it fly from the dotted line, a little bit high off of the glass, and tip back to Booker. Here's Soares. That teardrop is short. And an easy rebound for Destin Ecky. At 6'6", he'll be back next year, one of 4 juniors. Cards this year have a junior, 3 sophomores, and a freshman. That's the team that returns next year, along with 5 JVers. Nimitz won the JV contest tonight, so the younger bunch beat their crosstown rival. Hand off underneath from behind the glass, partially tipped. Shot taken by Pedro Torres. Yusuke Jackson with the game's first 3.
And just the first overall field goal.
Justin Sherman, bounce pass to Ecky. Ecky again working on McGinnis at 6'2". Chavarria works it out to the middle. And at the top of the key, the 3 taken and missed by Sherman. Long rebound, Nimitz.
I don't think they're exploiting Ecky's size advantage underneath enough.
He's got a 5-inch height advantage on McGinnis and a walking violation, and it's Max ball.
And Starks comes in, so all that's missing out of what I call the 3 sophomore sensations is Key, number 5, and they'll have all 3 of those out there.
Starks, here he is at 5'8". Right side to Yusuke Jackson to Zay Booker from downtown, and Booker with a net cutter. And the Cards with a three-point lead. Sherman. Halfway through the opening quarter, he is fouled. McGinnis thought he poked it away cleanly, but got the back of the wrist, and that is Mac's 14th foul.
Yeah, Booker was ready to set sail after the turnover.
Angel Chavarria in front of us, averaging 9 a game, and the senior with a bounce pass to Ecky. Turning, and a block gets it right back, draws the double team, puts it up anyway. Ecky, who had 16 in that first game, makes it a one-point game. Cards come right back and miss a three. That was Rodrigo Swords off of Chavarria. Jackson the other way. To Booker up top. That one curls out. Nobody underneath. And getting the carom, Myron Collins. 7-6, Cards by one, under 3 minutes to go in the first. Chavarria working on Booker, and Booker picks his pocket. Here's Zay, and gets the layup with his fifth point. A steal and a deuce. A three-point lead, and this foul away from the ball in the corner on Torres.
Apparently against Chavarria.
Was it Chavarria or Torres?
No, Chavarria. He's taking exception. He turned around, I think, more to talk to the ref than he was to Booker. And now Coach Donaldson wants an explanation from the official that called the foul.
Yusuke Jackson will play it in across the way. The Cards leading by three.
As we saw last week on ICTN, the officials are quick to interject and try not to let this emotional rivalry get out of hand.
It's Valentine's Day, and he showed him no love at all.
None whatsoever. Didn't give him flowers or anything.
It'll be a cliche-ridden night tonight on February 14th.
Love is a battlefield.
Hand off and a layup off of the glass. Swords.
Yeah, Burris, the freshman, nice little assist there.
Blake Burris, number 31 at 6'4". And the lead now is expanded to 5. Justin Sherman between the circles. Actually, he was nearer El Paso. On the logo of midcourt. Deflected into the hands of Jackson. Left wing and an air ball fired up by Starks. Fabian Hopkins. Right corner, Ecky. And straight as Cupid's arrow on the three by Ecky. Another air ball three. At a 24 to go here in the first.
And here comes Key in place of Jackson. So now all three sophomores and a freshman, the future of this Cardinal team, out on the court.
Yeah, you're right. See a lot of these guys next year. Torres can't have it fall. On the run is Starks. It's kicked and a block just to the right of the lane.
Hopkins going to be charged with that one.
Fabian Hopkins, the junior. On shooting foul, they play it in wide open off of the inbounds pass in midair, carry is Key. In one motion.
Vikings just fell asleep that time on the weak side.
Under a minute, the lead back at 5. Sherman gets away, takes it, tries to take it inside, jarred loose of the ball. Torres picks it up. Byron Collins on Booker. Trip falls down, but walked with it beforehand. Took the punishment, but has to give it up.
You know, the Vikings, they're just not built to have to come back from double-digit deficits. I think it's important for them not to let things get away here at the end of the first quarter.
Starks, right wing to Carius Key. Booker Down low, Starks finds an opening. He's the sixth different player to score here in the first quarter.
Well, that's what the Cardinals do well. They're a balanced team.
A lead at seven. Handoff on the right hash mark. And it'll go out of bounds.
Yeah.
Ball went out of bounds. And the Cards have time with 10 seconds. Booker with 8 seconds, not yet to midcourt. With three. With one. It will count had it gone down for Burroughs, but as it is, the Cards lead by seven. At the end of the first quarter, our ICTN District Game of the Week. The Cards leading the Vikings 15-8. John Nelson back with Rob Willman, our season finale in basketball. On ICTN, Nimitz will take possession of a first to begin the second quarter. Well, it's kind of sad when the regular season comes to a close.
Seems to hit so fast.
Hopkins is pressured, still pressured, and just throws it up. And over the top of Looklock, Starks may have got a top of the shoulder.
Yeah, that was a good call.
Team foul number five. But it is kind of sad. I mean, we've seen a variety of this year, Rob, Northlake and Branch View and all the urban schools. Kind of like the football season, kind of hate for it to end. Pedro Torres will check out. Angel Chavarria, here's Ecke. Ecke trying to get closer, hands it off to Hopkins. Sherman tipped. Trying to relocate possession of it. It's still on the floor. It's grabbed. It is kicked. And the Cards and a whistle before the three-point attempt by Zay Booker. Had carnage all over the place.
People were falling like dominoes. Couldn't figure out who the foul was going to be on. You could have also had a travel call at the get-go. Going to call that one against Hopkins.
That is his second and the team's fourth.
Martin was trying to get the timeout when his player had the ball initially.
Starks and Key. Entry pass. Burroughs. And then he drew a crowd and lost possession of it. And for the first time, Devin Johnson, 5'9 sophomore for the Vikings. Look from behind his shoulder. Tight quarters here. At Mac, Chavarria just flips it back in the direction of Naren Collins, who was there, and now Johnson in a shouting match briefly.
Well,
he
Johnson
has to be held up by Key.
Well, Johnson and Evans ran into each other, and Johnson thought he got blindsided by Evans. Let's watch the end of the play. Coming up right about, oh, he tripped him. So Johnson thought it was on purpose. Now we're going to get timeout. I think Coach Martin trying to get his point of view in on what had happened.
Johnson has been charged with a foul. That is the sixth team foul.
Well, they're definitely calling it close. MacArthur very aggressive defensively, and it's really giving Nimitz fits getting across the timeline and getting into a flow offensively.
Yeah, they've had a tough time trying to run any kind of a set play. I'm kind of like you. Let's use Ecke's advantage here. You're down by seven. Chavarria hasn't scored yet. He came in averaging 9 a game.
5 seconds.
Ecke will give it up.
Nobody came back to help him. It's like a quarterback getting rushed and it's coming out of the pocket and everybody wants to go deep. No one comes back to the passer, or no one's coming back to Ecke to help him out.
Booker from Johnson. Zay Booker's second three. And a timeout taken by Nimitz. They now trail by 10.
Last week, MacArthur started the first quarter, just bombs away, lights out. You know, they didn't do anything inside the perimeter. Then they changed the pace up a bit. But when Booker gets the basketball, this guy likes to shoot. He doesn't care where he's at, where the line is at. If he's open and he feels good about it, he's going to put it up. We've seen that young man for the last 3 years here on ICTN do that quite often. And when he gets hot, he's just going to keep taking those shots. But getting back to last week, though, MacArthur started out really hot on the outside perimeter, and they knew they couldn't keep doing it. So in the second quarter, they just mixed it up completely and just started pounding the boards and going inside. So be curious to see if they change that look here in the second quarter this week. But Ackie hadn't touched the ball near enough there within sight of the goal, I don't think, for Nimitz.
This is Sherman. Little bounce pass in front of us and on the line. He got the ball, but he also got his right foot out of bounds, Robert Johnson. And Siki Jackson now at the end of the bench, trying to urge his team to play a little good defense. Here's Chavarria. Cross-court heave. And the lefty fires and misses a three. Run down by Chavarria. That was Sherman who took the shot. Chavarria almost steps on the line and throws a bullet off the foot of Zay Booker.
Yeah, heads-up play by Chavarria. Double team force out of bounds. Had to do something.
They'll get it back. Little jump step. That one partially deflected. Chavarria has it. There's Ecky in the corner. The three-pointer short, follow-up missed. Chance for the Vikings to make it a 10-point game. Wide open and a nice spin move by Blake Burris. And the freshman with his first two. And the seventh different card to score. Getting out of hand already in the first half, a lead of 12 around one. Sherman around two, the handoff to Ecky, and Ecky scores.
Only Viking to hit a field goal.
His ninth point. Key slips it to Booker. Right wing to Starks. Robert Johnson thinking three, gets it out to Booker. In tight, turn, shoot, and the miss by Burris.
Good matchup between Burris and Ecky. Pounding bodies down there on the low post.
Sherman crossover. Gives it up. That one taken to miss by Devin Johnson. In transition, here Starks. Nice handoff, and Robert Johnson got behind Ecky.
No one blocked out on the lane. Paint was wide open.
The eighth different card to score, and the lead at a dozen. Into Ecky, working on Burris. In the corner to Chavarria, over the lid. Last touch by
Johnson.
Number 24, Ken McGinnis. And Yusuke Jackson back in. There's Jackson, a senior. He has a three. It was about this time of the year last season, Rob. I don't know if we're going to see the season-ending game we saw last year, the Irving Mac contest. That one intercepted by Booker, but then walked with it right on top of the line. That's a 94-56 Cardinal win in which Andrew Jones scored 46. Markel Cooks had 38 for the Tigers. 23 pointers in that game last year. The season ender.
Jones has had a great freshman season at UT, playing in every game. Boys had a great month of January and February.
Yeah, he's getting a lot of rebounds and assists. Intercepted underneath by McGinnis. Intended for Booker, who runs it down, throws it back into the court, and unfortunately Hopkins was there for Nimitz. Hopkins will hand it off. This one flipped up in midair by Sherman. On the floor, picked up, still loose. The dive, the scramble, and Nimitz loses it to Booker. Robert Johnson, and Johnson bottoms it out.
It's got to feel good for the senior playing his last game.
Team three-pointer number four and a 15-point lead. Cross court and caught up high by Sherman.
Cardinals are doing a great job of just double-teaming the man with the ball.
3:05 to go. Ecke with a 360 spin on McGinnis. Starts and throws it away. He thought that McGinnis might have been cutting underneath and throws it away.
Augie LaBella now in. We haven't seen Augie much on ICTN, but he's getting some game time now. Taking over for McGinnis inside.
LaBella, a 6'1 senior. Cardinals have been without Montrell Walker for most of the year. Batted loose across the way.
Coach Martin told me last week how much of a player and impact that has been to this team. He said we really missed his play, his leadership, his experience as a senior.
Devin Johnson at the line with a 1-1. That was Mac's seventh team foul.
Coach Donaldson in his sixth year.
That one off the back iron and caught waist high underneath by LaBella. The fast moving second quarter as Chavarria closes in on Booker. Gives him a head fake, goes to the left, passes off intended inside, broken up, and back to Chavarria off of McGinnis. Ecke trying to pick it up off the floor on the bounce pass delivered by Devin Johnson. Contact. Thumbs up. Long to McArthur.
Yeah, possession arrow to Mac. Last couple of times they've tried to get it to Ecke. He's just had ball control issues. He hadn't been able to really just get a grip on the ball. That's a travel.
Robert Johnson trying to free away from Byron Collins and walk with it. Winding down to 2 minutes. Davian Hopkins in the backcourt. Number two on number two. Zay Booker takes him to the left side. A jump pass into Chavarria. Can't shoot over McGinnis to Ecke. Ecke drives, was elbowed in the process by LaBella. And another 1-1 for the Vikings. Destin Ecke draws the bonus. He now goes into double figures with 10. Cans them both, wasting no time at all.
Love it.
Lead has been cut to 12. That one thrown away, intended for Johnson. Booker with a high lob. And now number four, Tristan Starks, checks back in. Hopkins, all of 5'7", almost knocked away by Booker to Chavarria. Cross court to Collins. Collins inside, and Collins went up and down and walked with it. Able to get a shot off on possession, which hurts. You're down by 12. Booker looking for Jackson. Gets it to Starks. Nice feed, wide open. Missing the 12-footer is McGinnis. And here's Chavarria for Nimitz. Angel, look at him split the defenders. He takes it all the way, but walked with it. Tough call on Chavarria.
trying to avoid the charge, and the official said he took too many steps.
Under a minute. 10 points in this quarter for the Cardinals, and a double dribble on Robert Johnson. Give it right back to Nimitz. They needed a stop. They just got one. Just 5 points in the period for the Vikings.
That last shot that was disallowed by Chavarria, that would have cut it to 10, and this would have been an opportunity to get it down to at least 8. So Vikings need to make the most of it.
Ecke from just inside the three-point arc misses, and a put back in midair put in by Collins. Booker, a little bit too much on it. Off the deflection, Chavarria with 20 seconds left.
There's that tough double team.
Intended for Johnson. Lead pass to Booker, and he took about 8 steps. 4.3 to go.
Ecke back here, meanwhile, on the other end, just a little slow to get up.
Chavarria with one. He will shoot from 20. Miss up high, and that is the end of the first half. It is all Mac here on senior night, the district finale. Our halftime score, MacArthur 25, Irving Nimitz 15. Back with highlights and stats on our ICTN Game of the Week. So it is.
Well, we are at the half, and it's 25-15 in favor of the home team. Not a really great game. We've had a lot of turnovers, but we do have some scoring, and Ecke is one of those. The big bright spot for the Vikings. Hits one there on the outside, try to keep it going, but no one blocked out the help there and the follow for the two for the Cards. It is senior night, so how about an assortment of senior scores? How about it? Jackson from the outside, Booker. We've seen that for about 4 years, haven't we? And then Robert Johnson, nobody there to guard him. He takes it right down the lane for the 2 points. The scoring in the first half, very quickly, not a lot of scoring. Ecke had 10, Evans had 4, Johnson 1, and then pretty evenly matched here, Booker with 8. You see the rest of the scores there, as it seems like everyone that has played tonight has scored for MacArthur. The key here for Nimitz is to get off to a good start, John, here in the third quarter, because they're in danger of seeing this one just slip away.
Well, Justin Sherman taking the first shot to begin the second half and was fouled underneath by Robert Johnson, his second. Nimitz now 8 of 9 in foul shooting. And the second as good at the first, and it's a lead of 8. Booker on the left wing, picked up by Hopkins. Takes him to the middle. He has Robert Johnson on the right and starts on the left. This is Johnson. Hands it off to Burris. Burris with a jump pass to Starks. And reach, oh, off with it. Starks. Got a pressure from behind by Ecke and turns it over. And the second possession for Nimitz. Again on the year, 0-13. MacArthur at 5-8, the Cards overall 11-15. A slip, but Hopkins are to save it in the corner. They'll reset it to Ecke. Shoots it over to Collins. Chavarria grabs it before Starks can get his mitts on it. Chavarria takes it inside, blocked partially by Burris and deflected to Starks.
Yeah, Burris just made him alter his shot.
Burris at 6'4", Chavarria at 5'10". Underneath, going left hand and kissing it off the glass is Swords.
It's See a little Andrew Jones in him. Soars at 6'4", moves the ball well for a big guy.
Ecky on Burris, backing in. Little whirl, shoot, and miss. Up high is Johnson, got inside of Collins, little rebound. Flips it over to Starks. One hands it outside to Booker. His long three misses. Booker slips down. And here's Chavarria. Again, has yet to score tonight. Angel Chavarria almost lost it. Tipped and deflected in the right corner to Hopkins. To Chavarria. Chavarria a little short. Recovery underneath. Hitting the bottom of the glass. And getting it back. Here's Sherman. And Sherman converts. It's an 8-point game. Johnson bounce pass to Soares. Chavarria picks it up underneath, and a Cardinal turnover. Sherman jump pass to Chavarria. He'll stop, and he will shoot and miss over Burris, who got him on the way up.
Well, credit to Vikings for trying to keep the pressure up, not get rattled, not get in a hurry.
Angel Chavarria at the charity stripe for two. Averaging 9 points a game. This scores his first. Carius Key, sophomore, in for sophomore Tristan Starks. Just to make it a 6-point game as Chavarria lines up a second. On its way and on the board. 27-21 Cards. Zay Booker, who landed a couple of threes with a skip pass over to Johnson. Looking, cross-court heave to Booker. In the corner to Soares. Rodrigo Soares misses up high. And that's Key, comes down with it and off the glass. A rebound and the putback, Carius Key.
Key 6'2", Soares is 6'4".
The handoff in traffic, the runner taking a miss by Sherman, underneath a miss. That was Ecky. In transition is Soares to Burris. Burris with a softie underneath. Changing hands and scores.
Pretty good move for a big guy.
And the lead at 10. Sherman to Ecky in a two-handed throwdown by the 6'6 junior. His 13th point. Entry pass to Soares, back out to Booker. They work it around the horn, up top for the three as Soares misses. Control briefly underneath in the corner. It gets away with 3:57 to go here in the third quarter. Back in is Jackson for Mack.
Toby using a lot of seniors tonight.
It is their final home game. Yusuke Jackson.
You know, sometimes you just start them and then you never hear from them again, but they're getting some time.
A little short on the delivery. Underneath was McGinnis. No team will taste the postseason this year in the IISD, Ecky to Chavarria.
Again, no need for the Vikings to get in a hurry. Still got a whole quarter left to play. Just run your offense.
Ball collected and given up by Collins. 3:10 to go in the third. To Ecky. Ecky and missing over McGinnis. Johnson about rim high on the rebound.
Cardinals fortunate there. Evans didn't sneak up and bite him with the putback.
Carius Key over Ecky and Chavarria. His 6th point. And a 10-point lead. Sherman creeping in closer. Misses. Picked off by Soares on the run, Johnson in the corner. And the 21-footer, nothing but net. His second three timeout, Nimitz. Well, team three-pointer number five.
That's what the Cardinals can do. They're a streaky bunch. And when they get those outside shots to fall, they look unstoppable. Johnson just sized it up. Nothing but net in the corner, his second tray, and that forced Coach Donaldson to call time and try to stop the bleeding a little bit. Man, they've got it within eight, had a chance to get it within six, and next thing you know, they're down by 13. Just about 2.5 minutes left.
And the band, what a nice touch tonight on senior night. Let them play.
You know, you talked about the fact that no one from Irving will go to the playoffs, boys or girls. Hasn't happened since the 2002-2003 season. But Ranch View, which is in our viewing area and technically in the city of Irving, the girls will face Bridgeport in the bi-district round. And you know, we had the Ranch View girls this year. They're pretty good. It wouldn't shock me at all to see them make it down to San Antonio for the state championship tournament.
Good atmosphere with the band here tonight.
Like the band. I wish they'd do that more often.
Chavarria and a little bit behind Hopkins, who was able to corral it. Well, they like to use the floor, don't they? And a travel on Collins.
I don't know how many times we've seen players tonight just the ball slip out of their hands. They can't just take it and grasp it cleanly the first time they get it.
On the boys' side, the Division I championship should be a dandy this year. It always is. State tournament time. The handoff to McGinnis. A deep pass to Booker. In the corner for a three, Yusuke Jackson, his second three. And the lead at 16, the biggest lead of the night for the Cardinals. Off of the square, Ecky.
Since it's his senior night, I think Booker should take one like to the white line of the volleyball out of bounds part, right? Right where he should take one that far back.
Be about 47 feet.
Why not? Just, you know, he takes such long ones anyway.
Going for the steal. It's batted loose. Booker ends up with it. Robert Johnson will take the three, and a rainbow three gets a high five from head coach Toby Martin. The seventh team three-pointer for the Cardinals. And they're blowing it out here, leading by 17. That leaner goes in by Devin Johnson, who just came up from the JV, averaging 11 a game. Terrence Donald, or Devin Johnson, is Donaldson up from the JV. Well, Rob, there's another slip down, but Chavarria a little bit too close to Booker with 34 seconds to go here in third.
You know what, though? That's what, only the third team foul combined in the third quarter.
The give and go and the miss underneath. With 27 seconds, and Ecky. Looked like he did the splits and traveled with it. There's head coach Joe Donaldson.
He said, I feel like I've coached 6 years in one season.
Game number 22 on the year for Nimitz. Game number 27 for the Cards with 14.7 to go. And there's a stoppage of play.
Hopkins charged with the foul. He fouled out against Irving when he had these Vikings last.
Team foul number two.
Hope the official didn't hear me say that.
I thought he didn't look this way.
He was right by us. I thought, uh-oh.
Trying to milk it down for the last shot. Carrius Key. He's bumped. No foul. Gets it outside to Booker for 3 seconds. With one. Booker off balance three. Hit the front of the rim. And we go to the fourth. The Cardinals leading Nimitz 42-27 on our ICTN Game of the Week. About set for the fourth and final quarter here at Irving MacArthur High School. The Nimitz Vikings across the way will defend Cardinals as he dump it into play in a wide open Tristan Starks. Starks working on Hopkins, gets around and shoots on the run and comes up a little short. First possession for Nimitz here in the fourth quarter. Right hash mark to Hopkins. To Chavarria, he can't shoot, tries to go down low, and some contact, it goes out of bounds. Goes off of Mac Evans, number four.
And again, the Vikings is having a hard time catching the basketball.
Soars. And he misses the turnaround from 14. Ahead to Ecky. Handed off underneath in the corner to Chavarria. Chavarria with a dip and flip underneath.
Pretty move on the baseline.
5'10 senior with his first two from the field, his fourth point.
Yeah, that's about half of what he's usually putting in the basket.
Mack leading by 13. Trying to end the year at 12-15.
Right there, Booker. Shoot it.
Right there. Come on. Well, he got away from the volleyball line. In the corner, Robert Johnson, and it stays in and almost spun out.
Oh, he's had a great senior night, hadn't he? 4 3-pointers.
14 total points. Team three-pointer number 8. And the lead at 16. Hopkins shoves it over to Chavarria. Entry pass to Ecky. Gets around Burris. Partially tipped from behind. Soars has a rebound. This is Starks in the middle of Booker. Right side, open, Soars. Put back, Robert Johnson got inside of Collins. Robert Johnson, who had 13 in the first game against Nimitz, now with 16 points.
He loved to play Nimitz every game.
Back to Ecky. Ecky goes up and is walloped over the top. Team foul number 3 on MacArthur.
That's a nice little pitch and catch there by the Vikings to free Ecky up.
He'll shoot twice. And again, does not dribble, wastes no time. Just takes the ball when it's handed to him and lets it fly. Carius Key in for Rodrigo Soares. Connects on the second. And a 17-point lead. So who wins state this year? Who do you like in Division I? Or there's
I don't know the teams around Austin that well, though, or San Antonio.
A handoff. Burris misses. Cedar Hill State ranked number 4 and Skyline's ranked number 5. Chavarria misses. Gets it back. Just picked it up. And we'll have an injury timeout here as Ecky helps himself up. Joe Donaldson wants to let Ecky walk it off here.
Watch. Ecky right there, just to your right. Oh, well, Burris just fell on him. That's like an offensive tackle falling on a running back.
There's a team out of Houston. Klein Forest is still ranked number 1 in the state. But, Rob, you look at this district. Cedar Hill and Duncanville are combined 44-9. I mean, either one of those teams.
Yeah, either one could go. There's the district standings. there's District 13-0, Duncanville and DeSoto 10-3.
DeSoto, defending state champions.
All right. And like you said, Skyline, they're 27-1 overall. So any of those teams could make a run for it. I mean, they could get to the Final Four. It's that unknown because you face teams, you know, you haven't seen before unless it's been in a tournament play. But that's all starts next week as the district is over after this game.
Division One and Division Two winners in Class 6A.
Soccer next week on ICTN.
All right, carry is key to lob it in play. Here's Robert Johnson. Johnson over Ecke.
Ecke didn't know what to do there. It was a two-on-one break. He didn't know whether to hold his ground against Johnson or hedge his bet on the feed, and he got caught leaning, and Johnson just split the difference.
18 points for Johnson. Ecke misses from the free throw line. Starks with a rebound. Working on Collins. And some contact. Myron Collins, team foul number 4 on Nimitz. Final quarter, 4.5 minutes left to play in the season. Starks misses a three. Blake Burris has a rebound from behind the glass and a jump hook in there. 6 points for the freshman. And they've hit a half a hundred, 51-32. It is all MacArthur tonight. The ball tip going for it was Key. And Key is hit with a foul. Team foul number 4 on MacArthur. Key's first. Javaria backing in on Booker. In tight to Hopkins, but he's among the trees. Could not get a shot off, and the pass intercepted by Starks. And taken away, circling back, is Nimitz.
Remember what I said earlier about Nimitz having to take their time. They could take their time. Well, scratch that. They've got to get up and down the court in a hurry.
Javaria with a nice drive, able to finish it off. And Booker on the run with a three, and that one misses underneath over the baseline and off of Nimitz.
And some more seniors back out on the court for Coach Martin and company.
And it comes to McGinnis. And McGinnis with a line drive three. 9 3-pointers tonight for the Cards.
Yep, that kind of night.
Javaria up top drains one for the Vikings. Well, Jackson, good intentions. He just kind of throws it off one of the, or near one of the Vikings. Giving it over to Davian Hopkins. 3 minutes left in the season, and a 17-point Cardinal lead, insurmountable lead at this point. Left wing to Hopkins, and the junior backs it out, working on Jackson, or just trying to stay alive. The sandwich gets a pass off to Chavarria, does a 360, and misses. Ecke owns the boards, gets it to fall on the way down.
Well, it's been Ecke and Chavarria trying to bring this team back. Chavarria the miss. And right there, McGinnis didn't block out Ecke. Ecke makes him pay for the hoop and the harm.
So Destin Ecke at the stripe. 18 points tonight for the junior.
Stoppage in play so they can dry up a wet spot there just to the left of your screen. Ecky fell down on his backside as he made the basket. Coach Donaldson has a few underclassmen himself and a JV team that didn't look too bad tonight in their game against MacArthur.
Our season while ICTN began right here, the Lady Cards defeating Denton. And our season opener, air ball caught underneath by Effie. Lady Cards with a winning season, but will not make the playoffs. The steal by Johnson. Robert Johnson misses the layup. Hopkins lets it fly from the dotted line. And all kinds of contact with 2:01 to go. That is a 17 foul committed by MacArthur.
Martez Cash being whistled for the foul on the drive there by Hopkins.
Hopkins looking for his first point, 5'7 junior guard. And he has it. It was 25-15 MacArthur at halftime. Ecky comes out. Points here in the second half by Nimitz. They will come up short. And in district play at 0-14. Under 2 minutes. Zay Booker with a bounce pass to Jackson. Return feed. Here's McGinnis outside to Robert Johnson. He circles, but got a wet spot where somebody lost some kind of equipment, maybe a contact lens or something to stop play.
Jewelry, some change, loose change.
Referee put it in his pocket.
Well, it had to be change if he put it in his pocket. Finders keepers.
Robert Johnson squares up, misses from just inside the three-point stripe.
That's just indicative of just how difficult this game is. You can't hit every shot, and he's had a great game. He's made a lot of shots.
Bella in there as Hopkins misses. Up high with a rebound is McGinnis. Outlet pass to Booker. Booker goes up and is run into, and now maybe some more separation. That was Mac Evans. Is charged with a foul. And it puts Zay Booker at the line for the first time. 5'8 senior with 8 points. He'll shoot twice. Don't take many free throws in the first half. The Cardinals only one of two in the first half.
Yeah, this is only what? There are two free throws in the second half.
And the lefty hits the second, got the right spin.
You know, Nimitz had very quietly got the lead down to 18.
And off.
Or 13.
Deep three missed. Yeah, 13.
Yeah.
Johnson being shadowed by Devin Johnson. This is McGinnis, tries to hand it off, intercepted by Hopkins. Trying to go down low to LaBella. Hopkins with a nice dish off and a shot taken and missed underneath with 44.8. And Devin Johnson would love to have that chance again.
That's pretty indicative of how tonight's game has gone for Nimitz, isn't it? Beautiful drive, dish, pass, and just couldn't finish it off.
There's a lid on that rim. Front court to Booker. As they play pitch and catch on the wings, they double team Yusuke Jackson with under a half a minute to go. That will be the sixth team foul. Mac not yet in the bonuses if they really need to. Yusuke Jackson at side court to play it in. And the deep pass to Zay Booker.
All right, Zay, get ready. I want you to, as soon as you get to this white line, right about there, shoot it, shoot it.
He's in the big bend. Now he's in the panhandle and lets it go. And Augie LaBella looked like he was in the turnstile as he kept spinning and draws the foul. And now the 1-1. Foul is on Davian Hopkins. That is his fourth. Mac Evans comes out. Myron Collins is in there. At the line, 6'1 senior forward Augie LaBella. No bonus. And we'll see if the Vikings take the last shot of the game. Ahead, and the foul on LaBella as Devin Johnson will go to the free throw line.
Well, only fitting that the last few minutes of this game is foul ridden. That's pretty much how we started the game until they got their sea legs.
And the 5'9 sophomore hits the first of two. Mac won the first game 59-48. 56-43, the numbers right now with 10 seconds to play. Yasuke Jackson to Robert Johnson. Johnson with 2 seconds underneath, misses, and that will do it as the Cards take both games this year from Nimitz. 56-43, our final. Mac has now won the last 10 over their crosstown rival. In the second half, 21 points for the Cards and 28 for the Nimitz Vikings. We're back with our post-game show on our ICTN Game of the Week. Cardinals win it by 13, 56-43 as they close out the year at 12-15. Rob Wilman with head coach Toby Martin.
All right, John, thank you very much. Well, it wasn't pretty at times, but it was a win.
That's been kind of the story of our season. Anytime we can get a win, especially against a crosstown rival, it's always a good thing.
Your 10th win in a row, so is it the coaching or you just got some good players?
Good players, good players. I've been blessed since I've been at MacArthur to have the pleasure to coach some of the best kids in the Metroplex. All my kids take honor classes, they're stand-up guys, and it really makes it easy to get in your car and come to work every day.
You got to play your seniors a lot. One of those, Robert, had a really good game tonight.
Yeah, Trey looked great. I was really happy with Robert. He's athletic, and I hope that he's given an opportunity to continue to show that athleticism on the next level.
I was really hoping that Booker could try to shoot one from about 40 feet out to see if he could make it. He shoots from everywhere.
He's done enough of that in his career. I'm just so happy that we were able to finish our season off on a win. These guys have been so much to me. They were on the bus, and a lot of them played the year we went to the Final Four, and they've just helped build that tradition and carry it on for these young guys.
You've got 3 sophomores and a freshman coming back next year. You hear the cliche, I can't wait till next year, but it really means something for you guys.
Yeah, I think we're gonna be pretty all right next year. I'm really excited. You would assume they're gonna grow, they're gonna hit the weight room, they're gonna be even better than they were this year, and I think we have a bright future here at MacArthur.
All right, Coach, congratulations on the win.
Thank you, sir.
All right, thank you, Coach Martin. Back to you, John.
All right, Ron, appreciate it very much. As MacArthur has now won the last 10 straight over Irving Nimitz. They close the year having won 3 of their last 4. Let's take a look at the highlights here in the second half as Destin Ecke crams in 2 of his 18 points. A handoff to Justin Sherman. Sherman with a nice floater from the lane. And closing out the scoring is Devin Johnson as he uses the glass. 2 of his 5 points. Robert Johnson getting most of the scoring here in the second half for MacArthur. Johnson finished with 18 points. They had a total of 9 3-pointers in getting into the Yaki Suki Jackson. And one more three, why not, to finish off a nice scoring night for Robert Johnson, who finished with 18 points. MacArthur had two players in double figures. Nimitz had Destin Ecke with 17, Angel Chavarria with 11, 28 of the team's 43 points. For Irving MacArthur, Robert Johnson with 18, Zay Booker with 10. And the rest of the scoring as they jumped out to a quick 10-point lead, led by as many as 16 tonight, as MacArthur wins at 56-43. Again, they've won the last 10 over Irving Nimitz, and now 18 of the last 21. Nice way to finish out senior night and close out the 2016-2017 season. Again, the Cardinals end the year at 6-8 in district play. Nimitz closes out at 0-14. Our thanks to both head coaches, everyone here at Irving MacArthur, our award-winning ICTN production crew, as they don't want to leave here on senior night. MacArthur wins at 56-43. For Rob Willen, this is John Nelson saying good night from Irving MacArthur High.